About a year and a half ago, the Holy Spirit spoke to me so much about the word opportunity and said, everything that I give you will come through an opportunity. If you don't see the opportunity, I shared with you about Oral Roberts saying the most important phrase, if he was about to die, that he would tell me and his son Richard, if he was on his deathbed, was your miracle is coming towards you or going past you every day. In a few minutes, I'll tell you about a miraculous turnaround in my life that came because I was a swift giver. God spoke to me through a profound scenario, and I knew better than to delay. Delay is disobedience. Delay is disobedience. And Pastor James Maina from the Wisdom Sanctuary in Nairobi, Kenya, you'll want to go to his website. You'll want to purchase this book. He has it available in every book he has. They're rich, they're substantial, and you will be blessed by it. He's talking today about Abigail. Remember the one who was married to a rich fool. She falls at David's feet, prepares the meal when her husband refused. And she began to talk to David. She said, the Lord will handle your enemies like a stone out of a slingshot. And she said, everybody knows about you. She said, you have no blemish on your record. She talked to the king in a man, and the king stood up. The other night on church by phone, I did a talk, Pastor, yes, on how to talk to a man. Yes. Because the woman that knows how to talk to a man will be given access to him every day of her life. Yes. No man can stay away from a woman he trusts. And no man can relax around a woman he distrusts. Yes. And when I was sharing this, how to talk to a man, I was reminded of Proverbs 7 that talks about the prostitute, and Proverbs 31 that talks about the Proverbs 31 woman says, in her mouth, there's the law of kindness is in her mouth. Abigail gave herself, her time, her energy. You said she was a swift giver.
Swift giver.
Because her servants came to her to tell her privately,
yes,
about what her husband had done.
Yes.
Talk to us about that.
I'm speaking from 31 Secrets of the Bible's Most Outstanding Givers, and one of them is Abigail, a swift giver. And sometimes your giving has to be swift. You cannot waste an opportunity. I read a story the other day that just blew me off. A certain elderly lady, a senior, walked into a store on a very rainy day. She was limping and looking like, you know, she didn't have anything to do there. And when she was walking, the people at the counters were trying to avoid her, thinking this is just one of these women who are idle disturbing us here. Finally, she went to a young man who was on one of the counters, and this young man said, can I help you, ma'am? She said, you know, I'm just sheltering from the rain. And he said, feel free, if anything you need, I'll help you. And later, when she was walking out, this man pulled an umbrella and escorted this lady to the car. And the lady asked the man, do you have a card? The man gave out a card. And a few weeks later, some people from France called this company saying, we want this young man to come and do a very big tender for us in France. This lady happened to be the mother of Dale Carnegie. Mm. Before long, this man was taken to France, and he became a kind of a shareholder in the business of that Dale Carnegie, a whole empire. Mm. I'm telling you, an opportunity is walking in where
wow.
you are.
Yes.
Abigail
yes.
took an opportunity, and she became the first lady of the nation of Israel. Opportunity.
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 Talk to us about adaptation.
Adaptation. The law of adaptation. I just said before that we all look at a chameleon in a negative way, like it doesn't have character. But let's look at it in a positive way. It knows how to harmonize itself in a place. It harmonizes itself in a new place.
That's good.
No matter how bad things are happening. And one of the men who knows how to adapt, I love him, is Mordecai. Mordecai in the Bible, he adapts. Haman is really breathing terror to him, but he harmonizes to that environment and his kingly difference comes out. And what happens? He initiates the law of obligation one day when he saves the king from being assassinated. And do you know what? When we take hold of an opportunity and our difference comes out, we initiate the law of obligation. Because the king asks a question. What was done?
Yes.
What was done to Mordecai when he saved my life? Anytime you take a hold of the law of adaptation and you step out and your natural difference comes out, you're going to initiate the law of contrast. And when the law of contrast comes out, the next thing that comes out is the law of compensation. And you're going to be compensated.
Adaptation is not denying what you need.
Yes.
But it's honoring the needs of another. Like Joseph when he shaved his beard.
Yes.
Because the Egyptians in those days hated beards, so he adapted.
Yes.
Esther soaked in oil for 12 months.
Yes.
Daniel studied conversation. Was it 3 years before the king would have a meal with him?
Yes.
There's something powerful to opportunity, an opportunity to serve. Rebecca sees an old man whose camels need watering. She said, can I solve that problem for you? And she became the wealth manager of Abraham. Whatever you're asking God for, there will be an opportunity. He'll put a door in front of you, and it's your opportunity to walk through it, embrace it, and receive it. The prodigal son didn't see opportunity. He woke up one day and said, Daddy, I don't want to hear your voice. I don't want to sleep in your bed. I don't want to see you again. Give me my money. You're going to give me when you died. And look what he lost. When I come back, I'm going to tell you about a turnaround day in my life. Stay with us.
Wisdom is the ability to discern difference in people, in an environment, in an opportunity. The master's secret of life is wisdom. That is why you'll love Dr. Murdoch's